Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's yours truly, and welcome to the very first Logan's Nostalgic Journey special. Roll the titles! Well, new storyteller, Jamie Davison 253, this is it. The moment that yous have been waiting for.
Brum.
We all remember Brum, the little yellow car that would always go out on adventures whenever his owner isn't watching, going out place to place helping people out and stopping criminals from getting up to no good, with a little help of narration, which was pretty obvious. But who could forget the amazing narrator Toya Wilcox?
It was Brum's day for exploring the big town.
Wilcox is best known for being the head singer in the band Toya, who were a massive hit in the 1980s. Her narrations were brilliant, entertaining, and very easy to listen to.
He brum, brum, brummed his way along the pavement until he came to the crossing. Hello, Lollipop Lady, said Brum.
Oh, hello, Brum, didn't see you there. I was busy with my shopping.
What shopping?
It's all the things I've bought at the shops for the weekend.
Are you all right?
My alarm clock's broken, Brum, and I didn't get up in time.
Don't worry, said Brum. They're waiting for you. Come on.
Anyway, that's enough about her. Let's start focusing more on the show itself. So let's dive back in and see where it all began 32 years ago.
Morse code still used for messages.
It all began on a TV show called The Secret Life of Machines on the 5th of February 1991, where we were introduced to Brum's creator, Rex Garrod, who actually presents the show with another man called Tim Hunkin, where Rex demonstrated this prototype of Brum.
So Rex, tell us, what gave you the idea to build this amazing machine and how does it work?
I built this little car for a children's television series, and I've hooked up the oscilloscope to the transmitter so you can actually see the stream of pulses that the car receives. If I work this switch, that's the one that works the headlights, you can see it just moves one pulse. If I shift that one, it works two pulses, which actually opens the door. This one works the steering from left to right, you see it's moving four pulses. This one is shifting five pulses, and that's the speed control for forwards and backwards control, and so forth. Each series of pulses work a different function inside the car.
Brum soon began his television career on the 26th of September 1991 on the children's BBC channel. The show was created by the production team, Ragdoll, who would go on to create other kids' shows of the 1990s, such as Rosie and Jim and Tots TV. The first episode of the series was called Rescue, where Brum goes to the top of the Birmingham Theatre building and being rescued by the fire brigade.
"Now, Brum, you shouldn't be up here," said the fireman. "It's a good thing we came along."
But being saved from a near-death experience by his owner.
"In time. It was the kind man from the museum."
"Stop!"
he shouted. Brum was saved.
And catching them two robbers who robbed the big town bank.
"He saw two bad robbers. Two bad robbers running away."
In total, there were 13 episodes of the first series.
Together.
On December 26, 1991, the first season completed its run. Later, the series would be published onto free VHS tapes, and the show would also be rerun on Children's BBC, which was soon to be renamed CBBC. Brum returned with Season 2 on the 6th of October 1994, and was aired on CBBC. The first episode of the series was called Helicopter Rescue, where Brum takes to the skies with the help of a helicopter to rescue his friend, the Lollipop Lady.
"Hooray! I'm flying! Brum to the rescue!"
Doing a spot of house painting.
"Big dum-dum, this is where we live. You saw me come out. I didn't. I was talking to Brum. Well, whose house is it then?" "Oh no, it's Mr. Brillo's house."
And help catch the big town robber. Twice.
"Leave him to me," said the Lollipop Lady. "Come down from there in the name of the law," said WPC Truncheon.
In total, there were about 10 episodes of the second series.
"And off he brummed, all the way home."
On the 29th of December, 1994, Brum once again drove off the air. Later, the series would be published onto 9 VHS tapes and were rerun on CBBC until the early 2000s. By the time the 21st century came, it seems like Brum wasn't going to make a comeback at all. However, on the 3rd of September 2001, Brum returned again with a new look and a brand new series. The first episode of the series was called Airport Adventure, where Brum helps a famous celebrity get her jewellery back from two baddies by chasing them through the whole airport.
Jules.
I know! Surely security would have stopped them. Rescuing an uncontrollable dog from a building site. And nearly causing a huge collision with the train. In total, there were 66 episodes of the third series. However, Ragdoll made a lot of changes to the show, such as replacing Wilcox with a couple of kids to narrate the series. They also decided to give Brum a variety of superpowers, such as being able to fly, being the second car to drive underwater, and this. That's not all. He also defined physics. That is why you should always purchase a case to protect your electronics, like mine, with a screen protector. So, sadly, on the 4th of November 2002, Brum drove off our screens for the third time. Later, the series would be published onto VHS and DVD and was rerun on CBeebies until 2012. It seems the Little Car showbiz days were over. That is until 2016. Guess who's back, 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 back again? Shady's back, 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 tell a friend, friend, friend. Guess who's back, 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 guess who's back. Well, YouTube screens, that is. In this revolting CGI series. Now, I have to say that this reboot is absolutely crap. Why? Because it reminds me of bloody Cocomelon. I mean, just look at it. The animation, the characters, the humour, you name it. This show is definitely not for us Brum fans, that's for sure. Then, Wildbrain gave us another concoction. This cartoon series called Brum and Friends, which is 10 times worse. How could this day get any worse? However, we soon had a miracle from an Aussie legend. That's right, the new storyteller. He soon made this better version of Brum, which aired on YouTube on the 24th of February 2016. The first episode of the series was called Brum and the Bible Book, where we see some flashbacks of Mike the museum owner when he used to live in Australia before moving to the UK, where he opened up the Cotswold Motor Museum. Flash forward back to the present, we would see our hero moving into Tasmania, where, in part 2, was chased by Mike's parents and his little brother, until they were eventually arrested by the police. Then, in the end, Brum found a new home, and a new owner to watch over him. Then, there's the time Brum met Tayu, the little bus and his friends.
Like me, which is a mercy.
On the day Brum and Twilight went out on their first date. In total, there were 10 episodes of the first series. Sadly, the series came to an end on the 15th of March 2016. And with that, the first season of Brum on his adventures in Australia has completed its run. As time went on, the new storyteller would go on to make a further 9 seasons of Brum Australia. We also have these old seasons of Brum Australia, such as the 4-year anniversary series of Brum Australia. But the new storyteller goes on to make more of his fantastic content that we all enjoy very much. And it is an honour to be a good friend of his. A new storyteller, I wish you all the best for your future content, mate, and thank you for being a great supporter to this project. And especially you, Jamie Davison 253. As time went on, there was no news about Brum whatsoever. It seemed that Brum has now become a thing of the past now. However, in 2019, a guy called James the Prop Maker had announced that he was planning to build his very own replica Brum, which he's still in the middle of doing as far as I know. And I am also a good friend of his as well. And James, if you're watching this, I'm really proud of what you're doing so far, and keep up the good work, pal. But then, James made a shocking discovery. He found the Brum prototype in the Motor Museum! And he has teamed up with the staff at the Cotswolds to restore Rex's prototype back to its former glory and put it back on display. And then, during 2020 and 2021, the worst years ever due to the COVID pandemic, sorry if I shouted, a YouTuber named MickeyFan1909 gave us another amazing gift. And just like that, another Brum spin-off series had just begun. Like I said before, subscribe to him. And Mickey, I said it before and I shall say it again. Thank you for giving us the best miracle of all, Lego Brum. The first episode of the series was called 1 month Later, where we see Brum, Mickey, Gareth and Oliver attending the funeral of Rex Garrod. Brum soon went into a deep depression and went off into hiding. As time went on, 25% of crime had increased, and there was only one thing left to do. Brum must come home. Eventually, Brum stopped Elliot and the robber from destroying the hashtag SorryBro merch, and the robber was taken back to prison where he belongs. And as for Elliot, well... Then, we have the time that James repeated the same accident that he got himself into, just like in Thomas and the Breakdown Train. And then, there's the time where Brum meets the Starfleet, until who should be voicing one of the members of the fleet and squirting Brum in the face with water but... Hey! Watch out!
Oops. Sorry, I didn't see you there.
That's alright. What's your name?
Yes. The new storyteller! In total, so far, there are 5 episodes of the series. But we're not ending here. We still have one more Brum spin-off series to talk about, which is Brum Big Town Adventures, which was made by my good friend, Jamie Davison. The first episode of the series is called Brum Goes to the Park, but unfortunately, according to Jamie, this episode has no dialogue. So from my point of view, it's just Brum basically exploring the park. The time Brum met a monster truck driver. And the time where Brum had a ride on a very fast train, which I believe, telling by its number, could be the Flying Scotsman. In total, there are 6 episodes of Brum Big Town Adventures.
She sure is.
Well, there we go. We have nearly reached the end. But let's take a moment to reflect. Brum isn't just a magical little car that just goes and drives off doing stupid things like Jeremy Clarkson. He is a kind and responsible car, and is part of our lives, and he will be remembered dearly. And he will always be with us, even if we're down, angry, or just exhausted after a really stressful day. And that is why, everyone, Brum will just be like a member of our family. But the one thing he will always be in is inside our hearts. Well, guys, that concludes another episode here on the show. Thank you all so much for watching. As always, be sure to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified when I post a new video. And I would just like to say another big, huge thank you to Jamie Davison 253 and the new storyteller. Without you two, this probably would have never happened. Well, guys, I'm going to end that video here on that note, and I shall see you in the next one. Bye!